Yep, that is me. At the age of 9, playing chess against my dad. He's the one who taught me how to play chess, and this footage, all the way from 1996, is the first time I was interviewed. I thought I would show this gem to you guys, because you know that my job, whether it's chess or outside chess, has mainly been related to being comfortable on camera, and also being able to express my thoughts in a relatively clear way. So those skills are part of my job on a day-to-day basis, but I wasn't born with those skills. And I'm here to show you how my very first interview went at the age of 9. Let's take a look.
Mióta jársz versenyekre?
Tavasz óta.
As you can see, I'm very good at one-word answers, maybe even two-word as a maximum. The hairstyle kinda remains, I'm just realizing.
Gondolom szeretsz sakkozni. Apukád szerette volna, hogy játszál, vagy pedig maga a játék tetszett meg?
Maga a játék.
És milyen ez a játék? Mesélj róla egy kicsit.
Játékos, érdekes és izgalmas.
Hogyan jutottál el Budapestre? Milyen verseny előzte ezt meg?
I have no idea why I'm whispering. I guess I was really intimidated by the cameras and the fact that I need to answer questions. All I wanted to do was play games and not be on camera.
És ott sikerült ugye győznöd, és így kerültél el Budapestre. Pesten kivel játszottál?
Bordis Lajos nemzetközi nagymesterrel.
Said his full title, International Chess Grandmaster. At least that was more than two words. This interview was actually made because I won my game against this grandmaster, who is not just a grandmaster in Hungary, but one of the biggest legends in chess history in Hungary. He was on the Olympic team that won gold in Buenos Aires in 1978, and he was pretty much my role model back then. And I won the game. I don't know how. He also thought that it was not possible, actually. After the game, he asked my dad if he was helping me, because he was also there playing his own game at this simultaneous exhibition. But no, he was very busy with his own game. I was on my own. I guess he just underestimated me, and that's how I could win. A simultaneous exhibition is, by the way, not a one-on-one serious competition, but it's when a chess master would go and play at the same time more games, more boards. He would be walking around in a circle, usually going from one board to the other, making a move at a time, and usually he wouldn't spend more than a second or two at each board. It's just basically walking in circles, playing quick moves. So it is not like, oh my, I have beaten one of the strongest grandmasters in Hungary at the age of 9. It was an exhibition, it was a simultaneous exhibition, but I think I was one of the only ones who won, and the rest of the people were grown up, so I am proud of it, even if my interview is not really my proudest achievement. But let's keep going, let's see the rest of my brilliant answers.
Gondolom nagy megtiszteltetés volt számodra, hogy őt megverhetted. Milyen érzés volt ez?
Nagyon jó.
Gondolom mindenki gratulált neked. Szüleid hogyan fogadták ezt?
Örültek neki.
Köszönöm.
And I had an almost immediate answer to other questions, but this final one on how did your parents take it? What was their reaction? Seems like it was the most difficult question in the world. They were asking me about the beginning of the universe. I had no idea what my parents felt when I achieved this victory against the legendary grandmaster. I just really had to dig deep and come up with an answer. Oh man. And that was the end of the interview. I just made a little, are we done yet? gesture. I hope you guys enjoyed this little footage. My father has collected all these old TV clips for me, and I do enjoy looking back at it and seeing, first of all, how I looked at the age of 9, because I don't really remember. I had no idea I was whispering my answers in interviews. This was my very first interview. And just a journey through memory lane, bringing back those old nice memories that, yeah, I used to be a talented chess player, or at least they considered me talented because I achieved things like this, beating an Olympic grandmaster when I was just a kid. And yes, it was a simul, but I take credit. No, really, it meant a lot to me back then, and I think it gave me confidence for the rest of my career. So I do consider this a milestone in my competitive chess journey. I'm not competing anymore, you know that I'm now mainly focusing on commentary, streaming, and creating courses. Speaking of which, my course is in its final stage. An update to those of you who are interested, it's in the beta testing phase now, and it will be out in a few weeks. I cannot wait. And I also promised in my previous video to you guys that you will see me on Twitch very often. I have doubled up the streaming days. I am now on Twitch almost every single week, 5 days a week. So if you need an online hangout, if you want a place where you can meet like-minded people, have a good time, and get through these challenging times in a friendly, positive atmosphere, we are there for you on Twitch. And last but not least, this little dude is behind me. The dear leader is behind me, because we've just filmed another TikTok video. I have my daily TikTok uploads as well. So, new course, Twitch streams, new TikToks every day, and I'll be here on YouTube as well. Every single week I try to upload for you so that you will have something to watch, something positive, something cheerful, something that can brighten your day, hopefully. I really am trying. Hope to see you in the next video, or on Twitch, or on TikTok, or on social media, or at my course. Have a great day, a great week, and just be positive, stay strong. We're gonna get through this. Oh my!